मैडम चेयरमैन, आई एम ग्लैड दैट वी आर हैविंग अ डिबेट ऑन द यूरोपियन कॉमन मार्केट. आई विश दैट इट हैड टेकन प्लेस अर्लियर. हैड पार्लियामेंट बीन इन सेशन व्हेन द मिनिस्टर ऑफ एविएशन ऑफ द यूके विजिटेड दिल्ली, इट वुड हैव हैड एन अपॉर्चुनिटी फॉर आर्मिंग गवर्नमेंट विद इट्स व्यूज, दस हेल्पिंग इट इन फॉर्मुलेटिंग द स्टेटमेंट, बट एट एनी रेट इंडिकेटिंग टू द वर्ल्ड एट लार्ज दैट पार्लियामेंट इज फुली बिहाइंड द फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर इन द स्टेटमेंट दैट ही हैज मेड. द स्टेटमेंट दैट हैज बीन मेड बाय द फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर इज एडमायरेबल बोथ इन कंटेंट एंड इन टोन. द प्रॉब्लम्स दैट फेस अस एज ए रिजल्ट ऑफ द इमरजेंस ऑफ द कॉमन मार्केट ऑफ यूरोप कैन नॉट बी बाईपास्ड. वेदर वी लाइक इट और नॉट, द फ्यूचर इज विद कॉन्टिनेंटल इकोनॉमीज एंड द इमरजेंस ऑफ द यूरोपियन कॉमन मार्केट ऑफ यूरोप इन वन ऑफ द स्टेप्स इन दिस डायरेक्शन. नो वन कैन डिनाई द स्टेक्स दैट वी हैव इन द मैटर ऑफ एंट्री ऑफ द यूनाइटेड किंगडम इन टू द कॉमन मार्केट ऑफ यूरोप. आई हैव डन सम रिसर्च इन टू द एक्चुअल पोजिशन ऑफ आवर ट्रेड एंड आई थिंक इट वुड पर हैप्स हेल्प द हाउस टू एस्टिमेट द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम दैट इज फेसिंग अस. वी आर इम्पोर्टिंग 35% ऑफ आवर इम्पोर्ट्स फ्रॉम वेस्टर्न यूरोप इंक्लूडिंग यूके. We are exporting about 40% of our goods in this area. We have a large interest in the outcome of UK's entry into the common market and the terms on which she proposes to enter into the common market. The present circumstances, we cannot visualize what the terms will be. But we know that our stakes are great and we have already indicated our deep interest in the terms which the UK would be able to negotiate. But having made our standpoint clear, it would be unbecoming of us to do anything else except to be prepared for all eventualities. I want the House to realize that while undoubtedly this is a great challenge, we ought to be prepared and not content ourselves with giving expression of certain views which might give the impression to the outside world that we are in a state of panic. To suggest, for instance, that the pattern of our trade should be charged overnight is not realistic. A changeover in trade is no solution. My honorable friend Shri Krishna Reddy pointed out that our balance of payments was most unfavorable with Germany. I know that it has been unfavorable, and while partly this is due to Germany imposing very high tariffs, let us realize that we have had to depend for aid and capital from the developed countries, notably Germany. And as such, our balance of payments is bound to be unfavorable. It has been recommended by my friend that we ought to think of the pattern of trade being changed so that the Eastern European countries might be our main customers. Before us, the advantages of rupee credit and rupee payments are dangled. I only want to sound a note of caution. While it is true that from the point of view of our immediate difficulties, rupee payments offer a solution in the sense of imports not being a current draft on our foreign exchange resources, we ought not to suffer from the delusion that we are getting something for nothing. Nor can we think that these rupee payments which are made may not work to our disadvantage. I do not propose to go into this question today, since the issues that merit considerations are different. I hope that Parliament will have an opportunity of discussing the whole scheme of rupee payments on some other occasion, so that we might have an opportunity of weighing the advantages and disadvantages of such rupee payments. No one for a moment objects to diversified pattern of trade, a structure of trade which is not dependent on any particular grouping of nations. We have emphasized to certain extent this diversified structure of trade. Probably in the future we have to emphasize it even more. But what is the position today? As it is, the terms which can be arranged for UK's entry into the common market are not dependent on that country alone. They are dependent on others as well. This is the position which we face. We should now find out how best we can line with this situation. There is one thing which has to be affirmed on this occasion. I hope Parliament will affirm it, because there is a danger of our overlooking it. To the extent that we suffer by the new groupings in Europe, the moral responsibility of these countries to compensate us is all the greater. This would be in conformity with the trend of modern things in modern welfare state. If an individual derives a benefit and others suffer injury, there is a principle of compensation or reparation that comes into operation in such a case.